All right, hey everyone, this is Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. This is exciting. I'm at Microsoft Ignite 2019. They've given me this awesome podcast booth here, one of 8 podcast booths. I get it for an hour. And they said that they expect me to record one podcast. I can do more than that. So let's dive in. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2292. Load to Power Query with VLOOKUP on the way in. Hey, I'm pretty excited. This is one of the podcasts I'm recording at Ignite 2019. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel Publishing. I want to thank you for stopping by. Now, you had to apply to be here, right? And so I told him I'd be doing some Power Query on how to do a VLOOKUP on the way in. So my first episode is going to be that. And what I have a CSV file that looks like this with date, item, quantity, and region. See, they have item number, but not description, manufacturer, and list price. And this little table right here, I need to make this table be part of that CSV file on the way in. So using Power Query, first thing we're going to do, take this table, make it into a table. That's either insert, table, or home, format as table, or just simple enough, Ctrl+T like that. All right, it says my table has headers. Now, they call this table one. That's not a good name for it. Let's call this part lookup, or item lookup is really what I would have called it. But here we are. It's already called part lookup. Now, our first step, a little bit annoying, this step. This is what you have to do. You have to go to data and say it's from table or range. This is loading Power Query. Power Query, of course, built into Excel 2016, available as an add-in for 2013 and 2010. All right, and there is our file. It looks great. I don't need to do anything to it. It has the name of part lookup. That's beautiful. But don't click close and load. Instead, close and load to. This is the most important part right here. Say that we're only going to create a connection like that, and then click OK. So that just defines the Power Query that, hey, this thing right here, this table, is known as part lookup. Now, the next thing we have to do is get that CSV file. So, data from text or CSV. So, sales data for 2292, like that. All right, they show me a preview of this. And then down here, transform data. All right, here we go. All right, it looks good. It has date, item, quantity, region. Yep, there's nothing I have to do this. So this is another one that I'm just going to load. Instead of calling it sales data 2292, I'm just going to call it sales CSV file, like that. And then close and load, but again, not load to the spreadsheet yet. Close and load to only create a connection. Right now, it seems crazy that we have to do these two extra steps every single time to create this connection only table one and sales CSV file. All right, but that's what we have to do. Now, finally, the last thing that we're going to do is merge those two things together. This is where the VLOOKUP actually happens. So data, get data, combine queries, and it's very subtle here. There's merge and append. Append means that you have two files with the exact same columns. Merge means that you are adding things in, like a lookup table. So see, they're kind of offset there. So we're going to use merge. And they want to know what our first table is. That's my sales CSV file. And then they want to know what my second table is. My second table is the part lookup. All right, now this is the part that I hate. I hate this part because it's not obvious what we're supposed to do. Like, you know, they don't say what you should do, but what we have to do here is click item on the left-hand side and then part number on the right-hand side. We want a left outer join, which means everything from the first and the matching from the second. Stay away from the fuzzy merge for right now. This matches 617 rows from the first table, which is beautiful. That's all the rows we have. And then finally, click OK. All right. I thought I was going to be done, but I'm not. Okay, part, or a date, the item number, the quantity, the region, part lookup, we're going to expand that. And I'm going to say, I don't need part number, because I already have that. But I want description, manufacturer, and list price. And do I want it to say part lookup dot description? No, why would I want that? So uncheck this box. Why is that always checked by default? Choose OK. All right, and there we go. We now have item, description. Maybe it makes more sense to have the description next to the item, so we'll choose just description and just drag it. Look how easy that is to do. Quantity, region, manufacturer, list price. Maybe list price next to quantity like that. Looks good. This is finally now when we can close and load and let it come back to a new spreadsheet in this workbook. Getting external data. Right, date, item, description, quantity, list price, region, manufacturer. Now, the beautiful thing is when this sales CSV file changes, when I get a new one, I just save it in the same folder, same location. And then when I refresh, I will have the new data loaded here. That's the amazing power of Power Query. All right, there you are. So, boy, we're coming down. Two seminars left. This seminar, I actually have a seminar tomorrow talking about Power Query. And then next week in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Then that'll be it. I've retired. I'm not going to be traveling anymore. I'll still do seminars in Florida. Feel free to come on down here to Florida on spring break, and we'll do a seminar for you. If you're having a controllers conference down here, maybe that'll work. Buy the book, Mr. Excel LX, the Holy Grail of Excel Tips. This book right here has all kinds of great tips and tricks on Microsoft Excel. If you like the tips on this, if you like the tips on this channel, please subscribe and ring that bell. That way you'll get notifications. Also, hey, because we're here at Ignite, thanks for listening to our podcast. We recorded at Microsoft Ignite, and Microsoft is giving away Microsoft Surface earbuds to our listeners. To enter, visit aka.ms/podcastsweepstakes. I'll put a link down in the channel before December 15th, 2019. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.